early photographic processes. Photography was invented in the 1820s and the 1830s. Many early photographic processes were invented at around the same time. Two main types of processes were invented. One was called a direct positive process and produced one unique photograph. The other type is called the positive negative process and produced negatives which can be used to make multiple photographic prints. If you are familiar with film photography, then you are familiar with the positive negative process. Direct positive process. What is a direct positive photographic process? You might be aware of the Polaroid process or the Impossible Project. A Polaroid camera produces an instant photographic print. We use digital cameras which produce digital images instantly, but digital cameras don't produce instant prints. In other words, a digital file is a virtual file that you can see on your phone, camera, or computer. But there is no physical print produced unless you use a printer to make one. In the days of film photography, you had to wait to see your images until your film was developed. So the Polaroid camera was a big deal because you could see your photographs right away. In the early days of photography, a direct positive process meant that you would produce one image at a time. If you wanted a second copy of a photograph, you had to take another picture of your subject. Positive-negative process. You may be familiar with film photography. If you shoot a roll of film, you end up with photographic negatives. From these negatives, you can make multiple copies of your photograph. This is called a positive-negative process. Which is better? So for some people, the direct positive process doesn't offer as much flexibility as the positive negative process, since for the direct positive process, you only get one photograph. And for the positive negative process, you can take multiple prints from the negative. Early photographic processes. In any race to invent a new technology, we tend to remember the first person to announce their process as the inventor. And the others get forgotten much more quickly. In the race to invent photography, there was a dramatic race to finish first. Let's look at one of those inventors who did not finish first. In fact, he got knocked out of the race when he was betrayed by someone he went to for advice. And he was pretty angry about that fact. His name was Hippolyte Bayard. Hippolyte Bayard was an early inventor of photography. He invented a direct positive photographic process. The resulting image was a unique photograph that could not be reproduced. His process is on paper and is unnamed. In other words, we don't really have a name for it. We just call it the direct positive process. Hippolyte Bayard met a man named François Arago, who worked for the French government. Bayard confided in Arago about his photographic process. Arago convinced him to wait to announce his invention. Why? Because Arago was secretly working with another inventor who had also invented an early photographic process named Daguerre. So Arago tricked Bayard into waiting to announce his photographic process. Because Bayard waited, he lost out credit to Daguerre, something like Shark Tank. He got angry and he made his image called Self-Portrait of a Drowned Man, in which he portrayed himself as a person who had committed suicide. The photograph calls into question whether photography tells the truth. Why? Because he did not really commit suicide. He just pretended he did in his self-portrait. Bayard went on to have a long career as a photographer. He worked for the Historic Monuments Commission. This is his image called Self-Portrait as a Drowned Man. On the back of the image, he wrote, "The body you see is that of Mr. Bayard. The Academy, the King, and all who have seen his pictures admired them, just as you do. Admiration brought him prestige, but not one single dollar. The government which gave Mr. Daguerre so much said it could do nothing for Mr. Bayard, and the wretch drowned himself." Bayard wrote this on the back of his self-portrait. It was like his social media post to protest being betrayed by François Arago. And I just want to point out a few things about this picture. In this picture, Now, this is really one of the very first self-portraits, I guess we could call it a selfie, that we know of. So Bayard is doing something really special here. He's taking, probably the first time somebody took a picture of themselves. And he kind of props himself up, leaning against the wall. And on the back, he wrote that people thought that his body, so he's pretending that he's dead. They said, oh, his body was rotten. It rotted away. And you could tell by looking at his face and his hands how dark they are. And in reality, Bayard was a gardener, so he just had a farmer's tan. But he used that to this dramatic effect in this photograph. So I'm I love this photograph because it was one of the first self-portraits, and it's also protesting an injustice that he felt was done to him. And I feel like that's a great way that artists can use their creativity and let the world know about something that they consider to be unjust. This is another portrait of Bayard, and here he is standing out in his garden. He loved his garden. And I'll just end up by showing you a couple of pictures. He was one of the first people to have the effect of objects floating. So these look like they're floating, but really they're just against a black backdrop. So you can see that Bayard was interested in that idea of photographic truth. So this creates the illusion that the statues are floating. And there he is, just sitting with the plaster casts. So you can tell that they're not floating.